Yo, what is up, boys? Welcome back to another video. Today's video is going to be me teaching you how to fight the chapter 3 meta, how to win against this crazy spray meta that we're in at the moment. SMGs, ARs, both completely broken. So if you guys are interested in that, make sure you like, subscribe. If you want to see more of these types of videos, tips and tricks, etc., let me know, because I quite enjoy making them. And the background footage for this video is from MarGFN. This is not my clips, guys. I repeat, this is not my clips. Please go give him a sub. His stuff will be on the screen as well. A great guy. I think this is a 30 kill game on 240 FPS, so just fantastic to watch in the background while you're listening to me talk about how to improve in Chapter 3 and how to counter this crazy meta that we're in. So, once again, if you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to like, subscribe, do that good stuff. I love you, boys, and peace. Alright, so the first thing I'm going to talk about is when countering the Stinger. The main and probably the only thing that you really need to learn to counter the Stinger is how to hit shots without taking damage back. So, a lot of the time when you're getting sprayed by someone and they're trying to get into your box, there's a couple of things you can do. You can either A, run, B, try and out-stinger them, or C, do what we're going to do, which is the most effective method, which is get shotgun damage back. So in this next clip, I'm going to show you how to do that without taking damage, without even like hurting yourself, without even putting yourself at risk at all. I'm going to show you how to hit someone for a big shotgun shot and possibly even eliminate them when they're spraying into your box. Okay, so right here in this clip, Lax is spraying up against my wall. And as you guys can see, as he does that, I'm able to get a shotgun shot off, hit him for the 138 and kill him without him even entering my box. So once again here, Lax is pressuring my wall. He does it with an SMG. We hit him for the 133 and kill him with one shot without taking any damage, without losing any walls, without using any shields. It's a really, really effective method, guys. Alright, so the next thing I am going to talk about when fighting the Chapter 3 meta is TARPing, is staying alive in endgame, basically, surviving in endgame. I'm going to show you a couple of clips now from an endgame 32 player zone wars that I was playing just now. Just watch what I do. I'll commentate over it. I don't think I got like any major wins here. I think I might have got one or two. I'm not showing full clips. I'm just going to show you clips of TARPing, clips of kills, clips of certain ways to play different layers. And I hope you guys look at that and understand what I'm saying while I'm commenting it. Alright, so right here, I know I'm 60 FPS, is a big contrast from the 240 you were just watching, but right here, I get a quick tag, and then I begin to TARP into zone with hard mats. This is the most important part of what I do right here. TARPing into zone with hards and knowing how to TARP in this meta with hard mats is just so crucial. Like, I can't even describe it. Right here, I think I go back TARP, because I thought I heard someone there. I think I was bugging the console. We were a bit bugging. I think I might have seen footsteps or something like that, but yeah. TARPing in hard mats, the most important thing. And as you'll see in my next clip, it can help you get tags later on for Storm Surge and other reasons. So right here as well, I try and TARP myself into zone in order to get myself into a better position. Hard mats, notice me stair TARPing both sides so I don't get hit. I drop a layer when I'm too high because I feel like that I can easily get sprayed out because of the spray meta. And now I'm in a really good spot. I open my edit and I look back and I absolutely beam this guy. I think down to really low HP. I get him to about 40. Unfortunately, I couldn't pick up that elimination. But it puts me in a brilliant spot right here because I have views on everyone. Everyone coming out of zone is guaranteed to be pretty much shambles. So when this guy comes out, I can box him. And I think I miss a couple of my shots. Yeah, I miss his shotgun shot, spray him a little bit. I don't quite get the elimination and I end up dying. But that's not really because of my TARPing. That's because of my own silly mistake. So I've done really well there. Then what I've done there is to TARP in zone using hard mats. It gives me a better angle so I can shoot this guy, get tags, etc, etc. So the final thing I'm going to be talking about in today's video is staying above your opponent. Right here, as you see, I hit this guy for a big tag at him for 132. Nice little bit of peace control as well. Right here, I'm trying to spray. I'm trying to get into his box, but I know that that's not really the best method now. Terrible editing from me there as well, but we'll talk about that in a minute. I try and get above him as much as possible so I can have leverage and heal, which is exactly what I do. I skip that bit, I think, yeah. But I edit that out. I'm now 150 HP, roughly. And now I drop on his head. But as soon as I miss that shot, what do? I get back up instantly. I get back up on height, so I have one above him at least. He takes height from me, like, momentarily here. He's healing in a box. I jump out of my cone, and now I'm in the best spot I could be in. I have, like, all the walls I could get. Drop down on him, hit him 64, crack him, hit him again 72, and win the fight. But the only reason I won that is because I had high ground. Also in this clip, I whack open an edit on this guy, try and bait a shot from him. I miss that shot, but I don't really panic. I try and piece him up a little bit here, and I hit him for about 20, but it's not really worth it. And he also cracks me. So I take piece above me into the side. I try and look for an edit on him, but he's gone up. He looks like he's been watching my videos. But yeah, this is a bit of a different example on when he had height, what did I do to win this fight? So this guy drops down. These are all random players, by the way. These are just Phil's and Finest. I hit him with a nice shot there for 90, and now I know he's going to jump in. I 100% know, so I place that ramp down. I try and edit it, but he breaks it just in time. But I don't panic. I put a cone down, and I hit him for 90, and I win the fight. So as you guys just saw right there, I just pieced that guy up. I pretty much full boxed him, but I missed my shot again, which is becoming a common theme. I need to work on my aim. But now I have high ground on him again, so I'm basically just playing height pretty much perfectly. I'm coning him off. I'm just basically just staying above him. I'm spraying him when necessary, but I feel like that's not... I don't do that too much because I prefer to work on stuff like piece control. He jumps in over here. I managed to piece him up once again, hit him for 95, and I pre-fire him with a 111 big shot. And yeah, that just finishes up the fight. But I was on height for most of that, so I was able to kind of control what was going on. And eventually I hit him for the big shot, but it's all because I hit him initially. He was then trying to get above me. I managed to get the piece on him. Then I hit him 100, and then I finished him off.